Necessity is the mother of invention, and we've realized this now more than ever before. With social distancing being a concern at restaurants, they are now being innovative in how they can provide the service to their customers seamlessly. Chaios, a popular cafe in India which started in 2012 by two IITians, now has 85 outlets in all across India. They will now be serving their guests through an app or an automated tea making machine called Chai Monks. So is that going to be the new normal for dining out? Let's speak to the owner of Chaios, Nitin Saluja. Hi, Brinda. Good to have you guys on Curly Tales. Looks like you're having a good quality time at home.
Actually, we are at one of our Chaios cafes in Galleria Market in Gurgaon. That is my favorite cafe. That is Brinda's favorite cafe. So we just thought that we'll have our conversation with you here.
Well, the desire to have a cup of chai in the outdoors, thanks to the wonderful weather, is at its peak right now. So tell us, if anybody walks into an outlet of Chaios, what the experience is going to be like?
Let me try and explain you the entire experience, right? You walk up to our doors. There will be one of our team members who will greet you outside the store. They will take your body temperature. There is a hand sanitization station outside. You will sanitize your hands. Once you enter inside, right, you can take out your mobile phone. You can just place the order on the Chaios Dine-In application. Just in case you don't want to do that, there is a takeaway counter that has been specifically established so that you can just place your takeaway order there, or you can place your dine-in order there as well. You take a seat. What you will see is that the seating at Chaios is fairly sparse at the moment. Once your order has been prepared, it will be placed onto a table, and you can just go pick it up from that table. Each and every customer's table is sanitized upon every use.
Clearly looks like innovation is the need of the hour, and I'm sure it will comfort a lot of guests who would be coming in at your outlets. I also heard there's something like a chai making machine that you have at Chaios. So if you can tell us a bit more about it, is chai going to taste the same?
Now, as far as chai monks are concerned, chai monks are the chai bots that make chai at Chaios. So this journey actually started in December 2015. So nearly 4.5 years ago is when this journey started, and we started to put a team behind developing this chai bot with one single agenda. We want to give our consumer a fresh, personalized, consistent cup of chai. So there is no chai that is pre-made at Chaios, which is handed over to a customer, right? So that is the core thought process with which Chai Monk was conceptualized. Little did we know that in times like this, the contactless nature in which chai is made at Chaios, that would become one of those key reasons why a guest would choose to come to Chaios or would choose to get their chai takeaway from Chaios. So chai at Chaios, all hot beverages for that matter, they are made using Chai Monks, and it is totally contactless. So it is as good as it can be in today's time.
So Nitin, we at Curly Tales, we all love eating out. Our platform is all about restaurants, going out, you know. But the biggest question in all of our minds is consuming outside food the safest thing to do right now?
Sure. So Kamya, this is a topic that has been talked about globally, and in fact, there has been no evidence found that. Outside food is not safe. So if you recall how when things started off in China, when things started off in the US, the different health organizations, the different governments, one of the very first things that got started was delivery of food and takeaway of food, simply because it is perfectly fine to consume outside food, and there should be no unfounded fear about it. Right, and especially for a brand like us that serves pretty much all the menu hot, so the kind of heat treatment that products go through that further makes the products that much more safe. right? So I think increasingly as the consumer is reading about it, this fear is weaning away. But yes, this is certainly a question on a lot of our consumers' mind as well.
Child as a brand is investing a lot into safety and sanitization. So is there going to be a difference in the menu, in the price? Are dishes or chai going to be more expensive at Chayo's?
So, quickly answering that question, the answer is a no. It is all these investments are being made in order to give consumer that right confidence that Chayo's is one of those brands that is investing very heavily into keeping their team safe, into keeping each and every consumer who walks into the store safe, right? And just for your knowledge, we've not taken a price increase at Chayo's since November of 2017. So we've not taken a price rise simply because we wanted to make ourselves more efficient with every passing year and not pass on any of that to our consumer. So I think it's a different mindset for us, and the consumers are not going to feel the pinch of what we are doing to keep them safe.
Any changes in the menu, the number of dishes, given that a lot of things are moving towards automation, but is there a reduction in staff also with that? And then the direct impact on the menu?
So there is no impact on the menu. In fact, we had a truncated menu during severe lockdowns, and with every passing week, we are getting to a bigger menu, which was the menu pre-COVID. And I think in next 10 to 15 days, we will be back to our previous menu. In fact, we are, as we talk, we are in the process of launching 4 new products that were not a part of Chayo's menu before COVID. So yeah, we are just going in the other direction just to be able to delight our consumers when they choose to come back.
Absolutely. And the desire to go and dine out is at its peak right now. Although there is some sense of fear. Nitin, I understand that Chayo's has about 85 outlets in all of India. So have all your restaurants opened? And if you can give us a sense of, you know, what's happening in Mumbai, Delhi, and some of your other cities. I believe you're also present in Chandigarh.
Yes. Except for Mumbai and Gurgaon, pretty much all other cities have allowed dine-in for stores to happen. And delivery and takeaways have been happening all throughout the lockdown. So ever since the country went into lockdown, Chayo's has been delivering to the guests and takeaways have been at us. What I'm seeing happen more and more is that the consumers are becoming really very comfortable in taking away their orders from a Chayo's cafe, which was earlier not a common behavior at Chayo's. Or let me say, it is not a common behavior in India in general to take away food. People, when they choose to go to a restaurant, they choose to sit there, spend like whatever, 30 minutes, an hour, whatever it takes for that particular meal. But COVID has just brought about this change in attitude of the consumers. And we are seeing a lot more takeaways happening. In fact, over the last weekend, we did more takeaway orders than we did delivery orders at Chayo's, because in the mind of the consumers, they are looking at it as an opportunity to go outside of home. I could see this product being done in front of me. I could bring it back with myself. I either had it in my car or I had it at my home. Or howsoever. In fact, at a few of our stores, what I'm seeing, it's a very funny behavior that our consumers are taking a product from the store and just eating it right outside if there is a public bench or a public seating area that's available out there, and they are just consuming their product. Because as you rightly said, people have been indoors for a very, very, very long period of time, and we all are social animals, right? We need our let outs. We need to be able to just get some right degree of change. So yeah, more and more takeaways are happening, and that's something that is very encouraging to see. We have these packaged products at Chayo's, and one of the biggest differences in our consumers' behavior that we started to see. So see, that's our Adrak Tulsi Chai Patti pack, that's our Masala Chai Patti pack, and so on and so forth. Let's say that's our Bhakar Vadi. So we started to see consumers order these products more and more in their delivery orders, way more than they were being ordered earlier. That was one of the biggest changes because people were super comfortable with packaged products. Early June, when people were like, boss, working from home is the new normal, and let us deliver whatever is the best required from our homes. Let us get the best out of our teams. Now they have to be at home. Let us find out ways, right? So that's when we started to see that uptick happening once again. And to your question, is there a new consumption trend that is emerging out there? Takeaway is certainly that new consumption trend that all of us are seeing around, because that is giving consumer a lot more comfort.
Absolutely. And have you done any survey to find out, you know, what is the process of decision making when it comes to guests wanting to, or other people in general wanting to go out and eat at restaurants? Is there a process of that decision making as to when and which restaurant would they like to go to?
So glad you asked this question. Some 3 weeks back, we did a very extensive consumer research, and the consumer is very articulate about one thing. I am willing to go to that place and that place only, which I can trust about their ingredients, their processes, and their adherence to those processes. If I cannot trust a particular place, if I have not experienced a particular place and I have not been able to build my trust on it, I would not walk into that restaurant. And I would just be very comfortable walking into those places that I can trust. So that is one very big thing. So what I see happening over some period of time is that branded players that take their standard operating procedures very seriously are going to be the biggest beneficiaries of it, because the consumer is going to be doing the decision making. Whether I have been there, whether I can trust this or not, right? And that's how it is going to happen.
Nitin, what do you have to say about the new guidelines that have been announced by the government in terms of social distancing at restaurants? While there has not been any relief that has been announced, there have been strict rules in place. Is that financially viable for restaurants such as yours?
So Kamya, let me just answer it very differently. Let me answer it more from a consumer's perspective. I would want to go to a place which I feel comfortable taking my daughter and my wife to,
right?
If that means there has to be social distancing there, then that means it is a must. I look at this decision from that angle, that I should do at Chayos what is good for our consumers, right? I think financially viable, not viable, I think this is a very brand dependent answer. It will be possible for some of the brands. It may not be possible for some of the brands. It is also a format dependent thing. It will be possible. It might be possible for some of the formats in food and beverage or in QSR for them to make it possible. It may not be possible for some of the other formats. So, but I think, is it the right thing to do or is it not the right thing to do? It is absolutely the right thing to do, because that at least ensures that our consumers are safe.
Absolutely. The monsoons are here, and I think craving for a hot cup of chai is again at its peak. While you seem to be enjoying it at your cafe, I want to know, what about Mumbai? When can we enjoy this?
So what I'm having right now is something called as Barishwali chai, which is our lemongrass chai, and this is one of my most favorite. It is actually a pretty staple beverage for Bombay as a city. It is not too big. This product, lemongrass chai, is not too big in North India or in South India, but it's very big in Bombay. So we are itching to enjoy these monsoons with our consumers, with these rains around us. As far as Bombay is concerned, dine-in is not yet allowed. Dine-in is not allowed till the end of July. So it will till then have to be takeaways and deliveries. So whenever you see an overcast, just prepare to either take it away from Chayos or deliver it from Swiggy or Zomato.
All right. Nitin, wonderful chatting with you. Thank you so much for giving a lot of comfort to our followers as well as your guests who've been craving to have a cup of chai at Chayos.
Thank you so much, Kamya.
All right.
Take care. Bye-bye.